grave could contain him. He will always be young in the classroom, waving an answer like a greeting. Buried alive? Alive he is, by the river, skimming stones down the path of the sun. When the tumour on the hillside burst and the black blood of cold drowned him. He ran forever with his sheepdog, leaping for sticks, tumbling together in windblown abandon. I gulp back tears because of a notion of manliness. After the October rain, the slag heaps sag, its greedy coal on his belly. He drew a picture of a wren, his favourite bird for frailty and determination. His eyes gleamed, as gorse flowers do now above the village. His scream was stopped, mid-flight, black and blemished with ill sickness he must have been, like a child collier dragged out of one of Booth's mines, a limp statistic. There he is, climbing a tree, mimicking an ape, calling out names at classmates, laughs springing down the slope. My wife used them. Her ears attuned as a using lambing, and I tried to foster the inscription away from its stubborn stone.